class 7. This is the another part of the chapter Rising Above Odds. So it's a revisional video. So we have completed the page number 13, though we have not completed wholly. We are going to start from the musical notation. From there we are going to start. Okay, so each letter, number and pronunciation mark is indicated by the number and arrangement of 1 to 6 dots in a cell to letter space, 2 dots wide and 3 dots high. So what I was telling in the previous video, it was the braille system, the system through which the blind people could able to understand. Okay, they could able to touch the raised dots, and by the touching those raised dots, they could able to read. There are some certain certain numbers, certain alphabets and words, alphabets are there. If the blind people could touch that raised dots, so they could able to understand what number was that and what alphabet. So by realizing this, they could able to read also. Okay, musical notation also can be transcribed into braille. Musical notation also, we know that musical, by making any musical instrument, by blowing anything, or by suppose like we are playing guitar, so that time also we need to learn the notation. Okay, so that musical notation for the blind people, they also get able to learn with the help of the braille system. So they can also enjoy the musical notation with the help of the braille system. Okay, the characters are embossed from the back of the paper, working in reserve direction, and are read from the face to the paper in normal reading direction. Helen Keller learned to transcribe braille on a slate by using a stylus, or on a braille writer by striking keys. So it was at that time when Helen Keller learned this braille system, it was not very much modern. Okay, so Helen Keller learned the transcribed braille on a slate. We used to write on a slate, and we that slate, by using that slate, she also had the stylus. Stylus means is a sharp pointed device. So she also had that, and with the help of this stylus and braille, slate, she used to learn the braille system. In 1890, after only 1 month of study, she learned to speak. 1890, she learned how to speak. She did not know anything. Okay, she did not know anything. So she did not, if a person could not able to hear anything, so obviously she would not be able to say anything. So the person, she could not able to hear, that's why she could not able to speak. But with the help of this brain system, with the help of the teacher Anne Sullivan, this Helen Keller learned how to talk also. 10 years later, she was able to enter Radcliffe College, from where she graduated with honors in 1904. So after 10 years, what happened? She went to college also, and after that she got the degree of graduation in the year of 1904. Okay, Helen Keller then served commission for the blind, and shortly thereafter lectured throughout the world. She wrote many books. She serves as an inspiration for other afflicted people. She was ever grateful to her teacher, without whom she would still be a disabled person and would have died without being known to anyone. So Helen Keller, she served many people, and also she lectured throughout the world, and then she wrote many books and many things, and always she helped the afflicted people, that means the troubled people like her, and she was very much grateful to her teacher who helped her to become educated. Okay, she was the one, that means Anne Sullivan was the one who helped Helen Keller to become a perfect person. Okay, so now thus the ability to do things successfully depends on your faith in yourself. Your teachers have faith in you and you should try to keep up to their expectations. So it's the ability to do something successfully, it depends on your faith. It just depends on your in yourself. Okay, so we should have that faith in ourselves, otherwise it will not be possible for anyone to do anything. Our teacher, they have the faith upon us, and we should also keep their expectation. We should always keep up their expectations. You should work hard as your teachers do for you. Teachers love all their students, but they give a bit more attention to the weaker students. Yes, teachers, they are always giving the attention to the students, and it is the teachers who are giving the more attention to the weaker students, that is the best thing. Okay, you should also pay more attention to your weak points and improve them. Just like that, we should also point out our weak problems. We should also point out our, that means the negative things. Okay, so why? Because if we just point out our problems, so we can improve that. Okay, with your teachers and parents' guidance, sky will be the limit for you. If we have the help, if we get the help from our parents as well as our teacher, so we can do anything. We can achieve anything. Okay.